I am Ra. I greet you in the love and the light of the infinite creator. I communicate now. Question 4.1. Questioner, when we finished the last session, I had asked a question that was too long to answer. It had to do with the shape of the pyramid, its relationship to the initiation. Is this the appropriate time to ask this question? Answer, I am Ra. Yes, this is an appropriate time space to ask that question. Question 4.2. Questioner, does the shape of the pyramid have an effect upon the initiation? Answer, I am Ra. As we began the last session question, you have already recorded in your individual memory complex the first use of the shape having to do with the body complex initiation. The initiation of spirit was a more carefully designed type of initiation as regards the time-space ratios about which the entity to be initiated found itself. If you will picture with me the side of the so-called pyramid shape and mentally imagine this triangle cut into four equal triangles, you will find the intersection of the triangle, which is at the first level on each of the four sides, forms a diamond in a plane which is horizontal. The middle of this plane is the appropriate place for the intersection of the energies streaming from the infinite dimensions and the mind, body, spirit complexes of various interwoven energy fields. Thus it was designed that the one to be initiated would, by mind, be able to perceive and then channel this, shall we say, gateway to intelligent infinity. This, then, was the second point of designing this specific shape. May we provide a further description of any kind to your query? Question 4.3. Questioner, yes. As I understand it then, the initiate was to be on the center line of that pyramid, but at an altitude above the base as defined by the intersection of the four triangles made by dividing each side. Is that correct? Ra, this is correct. Question 4.4. Questioner, then at this point there is a focusing of energy that is extra-dimensional in respect to our dimensions. Am I right? Ra, you may use that vibratory sound complex. However, it is not totally and specifically correct as there are no extra dimensions. We would prefer the use of the term multi-dimensions. Question 4.5. Questioner, is the size of the pyramid a function of the effectiveness of the initiation? Answer, I am Ra. Each size pyramid has its own point of streaming in of intelligent infinity. Thus, a tiny pyramid that can be placed below a body or above a body will have specific and various effects depending upon the placement of the body in relationship to the entrance point of intelligent infinity. For the purposes of initiation, the size needed to be large enough to create the expression of towering size so that the entrance point of multidimensional intelligent infinity would completely pervade and fill the channel, the entire body being able to rest in this focused area. Furthermore, it was necessary for healing purposes that both channel and the one to be healed be able to rest within that focus point. Question 4.6. Questioner, is the large pyramid at Giza still usable for this purpose, or is it no longer functional? Answer, I am Ra. That, like many other pyramid structures, is like the piano out of tune. It, as this instrument would express, plays the tune but, oh, so poorly. The disharmony jangles the sensitive. Only the ghost of the streaming still remains due to the shifting of the streaming points, which is in turn due to the shifting electromagnetic field of your planet, due also to the discordant vibratory complexes of those who have used the initiatory and healing place for less compassionate purposes. Question 4.7. Questioner, would it be possible to build a pyramid and properly align it and use it today from the materials that we have available? Answer, I am Ra. It is quite possible for you to build a pyramid structure. The material used is not critical, merely the ratios of time-space complexes. However, the use of the structure for initiation and healing depends completely upon the inner disciplines of the channels attempting such work. Question 4.8. Questioner, my question then would be, are there individuals incarnate upon the planet today who would have the inner disciplines to, using your instructions, construct and initiate in a pyramid they built? Is this within the limits of what anyone on the planet today can do? Or is there no one available for this? Answer, I am Ra. There are people, as you call them, who are able to take this calling at this nexus. However, we wish to point out once again that the time of the pyramids, as you would call it, is past. It is indeed a timeless structure. However, the streamings from the universe were, at the time we are tempted to aid this planet, those which required a certain understanding of purity. This understanding has, as the streamings revolve and all things evolve, changed to a more enlightened view of purity. Thus, there are those among your people at this time whose purity is already one with intelligent infinity. Without the use of structures, healer patient can gain healing. May we further speak to some specific point? Question 4.9. Questioner, is it possible for you to instruct in these healing techniques if we could make available an individual who had the native ability? Answer, I am Ra. It is possible. We must add that many systems of teach learning the healing patient nexus are proper given various mind, body, spirit complexes. We ask your imagination to consider the relative simplicity of the mind in the earlier cycle and the less distorted, but often overly complex, views and thought spirit processes of the same mind, body, spirit complexes after many incarnations. We also ask your imagination to conceive of those who have chosen the distortion of service and have removed their mind, body, spirit complexes from one dimension to another, thus bringing with them in sometimes totally latent form many skills and understandings which more closely match the distortions of the healing patient processes. Question 4.10. Questioner, I would very much like to continue investigation into the possibility of this healing process, but I'm a little lost as to where to begin. Can you tell me what my first step would be? Answer, I am Ra. I cannot tell you what to ask. I may suggest that you consider the somewhat complex information just given and thus discover several avenues of inquiry. There is one, health, as you call it, in your polarized environment. But there are several significantly various distortions of types of mind, body, spirit complexes. Each type must pursue its own learned teaching in this area. Question 4.11. Questioner, would you say, then, that the first step would be to find an individual with ability brought with him into this incarnation? Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. This is correct. Question 4.12. Questioner, once I have selected an individual to perform the healing, it would be helpful to receive instruction from you. Is this possible? Answer, I am Ra. This is possible given the distortions of vibratory sound complexes. Question 4.13. Questioner, I'm assuming, then, that the selected individual would be one who was very much in harmony with the Law of One. Even though he may not have any intellectual understanding of it, he should be living the Law of One. Answer, I am Ra. This is both correct and incorrect. The first case, that being correctness, would apply to one such as the questioner itself who has the distortions towards healing, as you call it. The incorrectness which shall be observed is the healing of those whose activities in your space-time illusion do not reflect the Law of One, but whose ability has found its pathway to intelligent infinity regardless of the plane of existence from which this distortion is found.